I just want to say this, and it would almost qualify as an editorial comment, but it's just something I kind of have formed some concerns about. I don't like to see people come into Alcoholics Anonymous and leave. I've been to too many funerals. I don't want to go to any more. I don't like to see people come in here and get just enough information to get confused. I don't like to see people let the light go out and wander away, and I watch it all the time. And certainly there's no pat answer for that. There's no pat panacea, but I've sort of come to believe that it's in the area of 6 and 7, in the steps, that this occurs, where there's an important transition that must occur, or else AA will become dull and repetitious, and in time I will have had enough. And it's a transition where AA becomes more than just a place to drop in and get what I need and get on with my life. If it stays that, I'll guarantee you, my belief is that it'll be time limited. So what has to happen? What happens in 6 and 7 is where the key decisions are made. Okay, you've taken a look at it. You know you're beat. You've taken a look. You know what alcoholism looks like. The question is, you want to get better, don't you? Do you want to get well, or don't you? Do you want to change, or don't you? And what starts to happen there is the process of regrowth, of rebirth, of regeneration, of restoration. And if all I try to do is get by on just surviving with chatty drop-in meetings and stuff like that, and I don't get into those transforming things that must occur, then I suspect that I'm going to have a time limited, and even if I make it, it's going to be an awfully hollow kind of recovery. Because our program is designed to help us become free. It's designed to make me a free man. It's designed to restore me to my place. I had one of the few advantages of getting old. Well, none of getting old, but of being old, as I had the chance to meet our founder, Bill Wilson. And I sat in, we weren't fishing buddies, not at all. But I had a chance to sit with him in Toronto and at the International 65. And listen to him, and he said something that has stuck with me ever since that had great meaning for me. And what he said was that AA was never intended to be some furtive hiding place so we can go huddle together. He said the outcome for Alcoholics Anonymous, the purpose of this program, is to restore to me to my rightful place in the world. And he went on to say, and I have gone on to experience, that we take our place in the world very nicely. And we do pretty darn well. You know, most alcoholics are sort of compulsive. Now, there are notable exceptions to this, and I sponsor a couple of them, that you don't have to say giddy up to them. Most alcoholics are eager to go. They want to get on with the business of living. And so those steps that follow, that 6 and 7, that critical decision of where I start to deal with the things that hold me in bondage. My belief is, that's just Tom Ivester's belief, but it's mine. My belief is every time I screwed over, misused, abused, took advantage, humiliated somebody, hurt somebody, every time I did that, I didn't win. I lost. I lost. And what I lost was a piece of my soul, a piece of my freedom. And my earnest belief is that I will never be free, never be free, until I go back and make right those wrongs. That's the liberation. That's the freedom. I've heard it said, and I've come to experience it and know it to be true, that if I practice these principles as a way of life, remarkable things will happen. There will come a time when I will be able to walk the streets of this earth and look any human being I meet in the eye. I'm here to tell you that's a promise that is real for me. I don't know of a human being that I can't comfortably meet. Not one. If there is one, I've got some work to do. And I can say to anybody, I'll say it to you, I can say to anybody, ask me anything you want to ask me. My life is an open book. If it isn't, I'm still locked in fear. And so that's where the surgery of Alcoholics Anonymous starts to occur, where I begin to get rid of those things that own me and start to have some impact on those defects that I described that came about in early development. Those things don't go away until I replace those with opposite values, and that's what this whole process, well, it's just a whole bunch more.